Consider a triangle ABC. Actually, our trigonometry is fully dependent on triangles and mainly on right angle triangle. This triangle is right angled at B. Right angle means the angle is 90 degree. Okay, let me consider angle C as theta. The side which is opposite to this angle is AB is called the opposite side. The side which is closer to the theta is the adjacent side, and the longest side of the triangle is the hypotenuse. This is the very basic thing you need to know in a triangle. Now, based on this, we are going to write the trigonometric ratios. There are 6 trigonometric ratios which you need to know very importantly. Firstly, sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. It is written as opposite side by hypotenuse side. So, in this triangle, for this angle theta, the opposite side is AB and the hypotenuse is AC. So, AB by AC. Sin theta can be also written as 1 by cosecant theta. Next, cos theta. Cos theta is written as adjacent by hypotenuse. According to this triangle, the adjacent side is BC and the hypotenuse is AC. So, BC by AC. Cos theta can be also written as 1 by secant theta. Tan theta. Tan theta can be written as sin theta by cos theta, which is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side AB, adjacent side BC. So, AB by BC. Next is cot theta. It can be written as 1 by tan theta. Also can be written as cos theta by sin theta, which is adjacent side by opposite side. So, this is BC by AB. Cosecant theta. Cosecant theta can be also written as 1 by sin theta, which is hypotenuse by opposite. Hypotenuse is AC and opposite is AB. So, AC by AB. Secant theta, which is equal to 1 by cos theta, can be written as hypotenuse by adjacent, which is AC by BC. Okay. Now, another theorem is very important to start with, which is the Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem states that hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. The other two sides are the opposite side and the adjacent side. So, according to this triangle, AC square will be equal to AB square plus BC square. Before going inside 8.2, we need to know certain formulas. Here, we have to know the answers for these angles. That is, what will be the answer for sine 0 degree, sine 30 degree, sine 45 degree, sine 60 degree and sine 90 degree. For this, we need to remember this table. But we no need to mug the entire table. Instead of that, I will show you a simple way to remember this table. Here, sine 0. So, it starts with 0. So, sine 0 is 0. Okay. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. Sine 45 is 1 by root 2. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. And sine 90 is 1. See, it moves from 0 to 1. Only this line you have to remember, and the rest can be solved by using this. Cos A is reverse of sine A. So, we are going to fill it in this reverse order. 1, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2 and 0. Now, tan A. We know that tan A is sin A by cos A. So, to fill this, we have to divide sin A by cos A. So, 0 by 1 is 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2. So, 2 gets cancelled and we get 1 by root 3. And 1 by root 2 divided by 1 by root 2 gets cancelled and we get 1. Root 3 by 2 divided by 1 by 2. So, 2 gets cancelled and we get root 3. 1 by 0, which is not defined. Now, we have to find cosecant A. Cosecant A is nothing but 1 by sine A. So the reciprocal of sine A will be cosecant A. So 1 by 0 is not defined. So reciprocal of 1 by 2 is 2. Reciprocal of 1 by root 2 is root 2. Reciprocal of root 3 by 2 is 2 by root 3. And reciprocal of 1 by 1 is 1. Now secant A. Secant A is the reciprocal of cos A. So 1 by 1 is 1. Reciprocal of root 3 by 2 is 2 by root 3. Reciprocal of 1 by root 2 is root 2. Reciprocal of 1 by 2 is 2. And reciprocal of 0 is not defined. Next, we are going to deal with cot A. Cot A is cos A by sin A. So, we have to divide cos by sin. 1 by 0 is not defined. Root 3 by 2 by 1 by 2 is root 3. 1 by root 2 by 1 by root 2 is 1. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2 is 1 by root 3. And 0 by 1 is 0. That's all. So no need to mug this table. Instead, by just knowing what is the answers for sin A, we can fill this entire table. Trigonometric ratios of complementary angles. Okay, firstly, what are complementary angles? When the sum of two angles is equal to 90 degrees, then both the angles are said to be complementary to each other. Okay, now what are we going to do with this? Oh, let's see that. Sin 90 degree minus A can be written as cos A. Okay, which means that cos A can be in turn written as sin 90 minus A. Similarly, tan 90 minus A can be written as cot A. Secant 90 minus A can be written as cosecant A. Cos 90 minus A can be written as sin A. Cot 90 minus A can be written as tan A. Cosecant 90 minus A can also be written as secant A. Trigonometric identities. We need these three identities to solve exercise 8.4. Cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So, when we add cos square A plus sin square A, the answer is 1. Similarly, 1 plus tan square A can be written as secant squared A. 1 plus tan square A can be written as secant squared A. Similarly, cot square A plus 1 can be written as cosecant squared A. So, we need these three formulas very importantly to solve exercise 8.4.